six rounds, this scheduled in the super lightweight division. Your three judges scoring at ringside, Kermit Bayliss, Max DeLuca, and Glenn Feldman. And when the action begins inside the ring, referee in charge, Hall of Famer, Robert Burr. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white, trimmed in red and green, he weighed in officially 140 pounds even. In eight professional bouts, his record, 7 victories, 1 defeat, 2 wins, coming by way of knockout, fighting out of and representing El Paso, Texas, here is Cesar Valenzuela. And across the ring stands his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with gold. He also weighed in 140 pounds. In 6 professional bouts, he stands perfect. 6 victories, no defeats. All 6 wins coming by way of knockout from Dallas, Texas. Here is the undefeated, hard-hitting, super lightweight, Virgil Ortiz.
Gentlemen, you had your instructions in the dressing room. The only thing I remind you of now, when I tell you stop, what that means is stop whatever you're doing, give me a clean break. Protect yourself at all times, obey my commands at all times. Gentlemen, let's do it.
We're ready to go. Hall of Famer Robert Burr, third man in the ring. Virgil Ortiz, Cesar Valenzuela, ready to get going on the night of Gennady Golovkin and Triple G. That fight can be ordered at ringtv.com. There you see 19-year-old Virgil Ortiz. Underway in this scrap, Virgil from Dallas, Texas. Trains in Indio, California, Coachella Valley. That's where his trainer, Joel Diaz, is at. Base, of course, Joel Diaz, you guys know the name. World champion Timothy Bradley was with him. Now training Lucas Matisse, a great stable that he has in the desert.
And he is very high on Ortiz.
And he doesn't praise anybody.
No, you're right. When he says a young man has promise, that young man better be good. And he knows talent when he sees one. He came from a fighting family himself.
His brother Tonio also in the corner.
What a pleasure it was watching Antonio Diaz fight. Let's talk about an all-action fighter. Joel was more of the boxer of the group, along with Julio. He was kind of like a boxer-puncher. He was a good blend of the two styles. And Virgil Ortiz is a blend of competent boxing and power punching. You mentioned his extensive amateur career. I'd definitely say he's one of those amateurs who's better suited for the professional ranks. The manner in which his, not just the manner in which he fights, but his mentality. You could tell he wants to whack guys out of there.
His last fight, Ortiz got that knockout in the last round.
Stop, record.
His undefeated record with all knockouts, perfect.
And sometimes I think he looks too hard for the knockout. Sometimes I think he loads up a little bit too much. Sometimes I think he throws too many punches too early. And he's very busy in this opening round. Usually the first round, you're supposed to feel your opponent out, kind of assess your opponent's style. Try to seize control of the tempo without overextending yourself, and it looks like Ortiz just kind of wanted to come out here and make something sensational happen.
No, slip.
That's a slip.
Get up.
Valenzuela, 31 years old, El Paso, Texas. Was away from the sport for a few years. There's some blood from the right eyebrow of Valenzuela. You see the punches that Ortiz throws with authority. With purpose, as we were talking about earlier.
Yeah, they've begun to take effect. It could have been from a clash of heads. Maybe that's what produced that mark on the right side of his face. He's pawing at it, but Ortiz has landed a few shots high on the head of Valenzuela, and that can make you feel dizzy, make your legs feel light.
Body shot will make you feel light.
Man, make you feel heavy.
Take you to that.
So heavy you hit the canvas. And that was enough. That right cross landed sort of on the temple.
Final seconds of the opening round to a youngster in Virgil Ortiz. Another body shot that moves away. Valenzuela. Strong round for the kid from Barry Towns.
Hey, I want you to keep walking them down, right?
Yeah.
I want you to keep working him down, but when he's leaning this way, he's leaning to your left. See, jab, left uppercut, boom, left hook. You all right? Okay. See, you hurt him twice already. If you really time him, that left part, that...
Ortiz comes right over the top with the right cross that lands right to the temple. Knocks Valenzuela's head over to the side. May have momentarily stunned him.
Cesar Valenzuela, 7-1. From El Paso, Texas. Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, working our way towards the main event tonight of Canelo Alvarez and Gennady Golovkin. Valenzuela, he did go the distance with Alexis Rocha. He was 47, which was his first fight in almost 3 years. This is more of his natural weight that he wanted to fight at, a 140.
So when he fought Lex, he had been away from boxing almost for 3 years, and he goes the distance with that monster?
Yeah. And well,
this is a tough cat.
The last couple rounds, he kind of kept his distance, too.
Yeah.
We worked out at the Palazzo Theater in downtown Los Angeles, and you can see that Valenzuela is starting to feel the effects of those body shots.
Yes.
Valenzuela's a part-time fighter, Doug. He's a software engineer with a degree in engineering from UTEP.
Let him go.
So
let him go.
Oh, that was right to the solar plexus.
That body shot got him.
Two, three.
You saw that right away, Doug, and woo.
5, 6.
Takes your win.
7, 8, you good?
Yes,
go.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Virgil Ortiz, 6-0. Grand Prairie, Texas Gopher alum, ran cross country there.
Valenzuela handled that knockout.
That got him good.
It was to the solar plexus again. That left.
I don't know if he's getting up from this one, Doug. That uppercut got him.
I don't think he's done.
Seven.
He's done.
He's done. You got to know when you're done. And Virgil Ortiz, a kid who doesn't talk much, he stays in his room in Indio, is teaching himself how to play the guitar and the keyboard. And right now, his grandma Frances and Mela and everybody back in Grand Prairie, Texas, your kid is now 7-0 with 7 KOs. A career that started with Gene at the Rivero Boxing Gym is now having this kid in Las Vegas looking stunning for Golden Boy Promotion.
Well, this 19-year-old introvert has a very promising future. He is just fun to watch because he's so busy and every punch is so hard, but his punch selection, it's the right punch. He's deadly accurate. And I was about to say that Valenzuela handled that first knockdown well because he took his time getting up, but the second one, he knew when to stay down. That was a short left, probably traveled 6 inches right to the solar plexus, right between the rib cages, right to the heart, right to the sternum area, and that takes all your wind. Here's another angle.
Boom.
Beautiful leverage.
I'd rather keep it like that.
And he was kind of holding a little bit.
Now, Ortiz won't let that happen, though. He won't let you tie him up. That was the first knockdown. He went down, specked that Mathis out. Or maybe that was the second knockdown. I mean, it was the first knockdown. He went down and he thought about it.
The second one was the uppercut.
Right.
Let's see, look at the second knockdown. This is the one.
See, Beto, I think it was to the chest. I don't think it was to the jaw, but we'll see again. Boom, yeah. It was a left to the chest again.
A left to the chest.
And then he spat it out, tried to catch it to say, hey, man, I'm done. Let's watch. It was both.
Yeah.
It was a left to the chest and then a right to the chin. Double whammy. And at once, Valenzuela knew that he had had enough.
Yeah, that replay. Whew. 19 years old.
7-0, 7 knockouts.
7-0, 7 KOs. And Joe Martinez, our ring announcer. Let's go, Joe.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 1:22, round number 2. Referee Robert Bird puts a halt to the bout. We have your winner by TKO victory and 7 straight victories, 7 straight knockouts. He is still undefeated, Virgil Ortiz.
Virgil Ortiz, Grand Prairie's own. Goes back to Texas, 7-0.
He's got a lot of physical tools. He's tall, he's rangy. got power. Yeah, Valenzuela saying future world champion. Yeah, I think I agree with you. Can punch with both hands. Yeah, just and he just such a variety of power punches as well.
And it's not like, you know, Valenzuela knew when he was defeated. And he even told Robert Byrd, I'm done. And he was counting.
He did.
Because he took the shot to solar plex, which a lot of guys would have stayed down from.
Right.
Then he got hit in the chest again, and then the uppercut that finished it. I mean, I give Valenzuela a lot of credit. You mentioned he's a part-time fighter, but to even just take this fight, because right. A lot of guys, Roberto Diaz was telling me, is having trouble finding Virgil Ortiz opponents that can give him